Next, you will see how to perform various mathematical operations on nd arrays. Let's use a random array of integers. Let's create an array with shape 5 rows and 4 columns. Let's see the output. So here's an array with 5 rows, 4 columns and all the values between the range 0 and 10. Note how we used seed the random number generator with a constant to get the same sequence of numbers every time. Let's run again and see if the output remains the same. You can see that we have the same values for the array. Summing all the elements in an array is as simple as calling the function sum on the array. Here is our array A and we call the sum function on it. Let's check the output. This is our array and this is sum of all the elements present in the array, which comes out to be 79. We can also sum in a specific direction of the array. What I mean by direction is along rows or columns. NumPy gives this direction a special name. It is called axis. Axis is equal to 0 signifies rows and axis is equal to 1 indicates columns. Remember this terminology as you will use it frequently. Let's code to make things clear. Passing the parameter axis along with a specific value will give you the sum along that axis. To understand this, let's first see the output. To get the sum of each column, we pass the value to the axis attribute as 0. And to get the sum of the rows, we pass the value as 1. To understand this, imagine if you wanted to sum the values of each column, what would you iterate on? You would say something like, for each column, sum all the values of each row of that column. So you would essentially iterate over the rows. Hence we pass axis equal to 0 to compute column sums and similarly axis equal to 1 for row sums. Observe the output when we pass axis equal to 0. We get 4 values. These are basically the sum of each columns. And when we pass axis equal to 1, we get 5 values, which are sum of each rows. Let's go ahead and try some basic operation like finding minimum, maximum and mean of an array. So if I want minimum along columns, I have to go through each row of each column, so axis equal to 0, to get the minimum of each column. To get the maximum of each row, similarly we call a max function and pass axis equal to 1. Just calling a.mean, that is array.mean, will give us the mean of the entire array. Of course, we can get mean along each axis as we did for max and min. Observe the output. Minimum of the first column is 1, which is showed over here. This value is essentially minimum of the first column. This is of second, this is of third, and this is of fourth. Similarly, for maximum of the each row, you can observe that for the first row, the maximum is 5 and it is shown here. The mean of all the elements is 3.95, which is calculated using the mean function. There are many more functions which you can experiment with. Check the documentation link in the instructor's notes.